Mitch Daniels was the governor of Indiana. Now he is the president of Purdue. But back when he was governor, he asked his staff to look into what they might be able to do. He said, now that this old man has kicked the bucket, can we finally stop taking it on the chin? Can we find an excuse, whatever one will work, to ban all the books of Howard Zinn? I want to ban them, he said, from the libraries. I want to ban them from each curriculum. Ban them from the grade schools, ban them from the high schools, ban them from each college syllabi. And quietly the books started disappearing. They're in the heartland of the free. But oops, now we know, 'cause his emails are public and were discovered by a reporter from AP. They're banning books in Indiana. The governor wants to censor what you read, because a patriotic history of half-truths and lies is all the history you need. The story hit the presses at least a bit, and Mitch Daniels then denied the truth. Which is funny, because that's just like the diet of nonsense Mr. Daniels would feed to the youth. American democracy is the best in the world, and everything is going according to plan. And any pesky historians who want to expose that crap, it's time to burn and censor and ban. They're banning books in Indiana. The governor wants to censor what you read, because a patriotic history of half-truths and lies is all the history you need. Can't handle reality. It needs to be bleached and masticated. Red, white, and blue are the colors for Mitch. Shades of gray are far too complicated. Columbus discovered America. It's the world's best democracy, and America always wins. And if sometimes things don't go quite the way they should, Jesus will forgive our sins. They're banning books in Indiana. The governor wants to censor what you read, because a patriotic history of half-truths and lies is all the history you need. They're banning books in Indiana. The governor wants to censor what you read, because a patriotic history of half-truths and lies is all the history you need.